Let's see. What am I learning today? Huh? What are these things? I should call BioFriend. Hello, BioFriend. Do you know anything about insects?
You mean insect? A bug?
You mean a computer bug? No, I can't get a computer bug. Shut me down! Shut me down! Ah!
No, Cosmo. Insects are tiny animals. Scientists think that there are 10 quintillion insects on Earth.
10 quintillion? That's a lot. I'll never get this chapter finished. But BioFriend said that insects are tiny. Well, then they can't be that important. What if all the insects on Earth disappeared? Let's see if anything important has changed. Weird. The Earth seems to be missing a lot of animals. Did you know that over half of all known animals on Earth are insects? But why did all the other animals go missing? Oh, I get it. It's because insects are an important food source for many other animals. The anteater uses its long, skinny tongue to scoop up 35,000 ants and termites each day. The little owl sits on its perch and looks for insects to eat. The praying mantis patiently waits for insects to pass by, then grabs them with its large, spiky front legs. If all the insects on Earth disappear, all these animals wouldn't have anything to eat. But I'm sure humans will be okay, right? Huh? Why are the grocery store shelves empty? Oh no! It's because almost one out of every three bites of food exists because of insects. Insects like bees, butterflies, moths, and beetles act as pollinators. Pollinators visit flowers looking for food. They accidentally brush against the flower and some pollen sticks to their body. As they travel from flower to flower, the pollen they're carrying brushes against the next flower, and some falls off. Pumpkins, watermelons, apples, avocados, and chocolate cacao beans only grow with the help of pollinators.
Whee!
Ew! What a mess! Ugh! All the animals on Earth make between 2.6 million to 132 million gallons of poop every minute. If there were no insects, there wouldn't be anybody to clean it up. Insects are the Earth's cleanup crew. Look at this dung beetle. He's using his legs and mouth to roll a ball of poop to impress the females.
Heh.
The poop ball can take half an hour to roll and weigh up to 50 times his own weight. Once the male finds a female who is impressed by his ball of poo, they bury their dung ball in the soil. The female then lays a single egg within the poo ball, and when the baby hatches, it enjoys a nice meal of poop. Yuck!
Cosmo, are you running a simulation right now?
Yes, I made all the insects disappear. Why? Is there a problem?
My pet gecko disappeared. I can't find any food to eat, and there's poop everywhere! End the simulation!
I guess the Earth really does need insects. Is there something I can do to help?
We can all help by keeping the environment healthy. You can plant your favorite trees and flowers so insects have food and a place to live. And stop using pesticides and bug zappers because they kill them.
Phew, I guess life is better with insects. That's the perfect end to my insect chapter. Bye! Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Uh-oh.
Hey, everyone. Cosmo here. Insects are all around us. What if you challenged a friend to an insect scavenger hunt? This scavenger hunt works best in the spring, summer, or fall. Step 1. Find a partner. You'll each need a piece of paper and a pencil. Step 2. Decide where to conduct your scavenger hunt. The backyard? A walk through your neighborhood? Step 3. Each person makes a list of between 5 and 10 things for the other person to look for on the scavenger hunt. Your list might include things like a butterfly, an insect with spots, or an insect pollinating a flower. Step 4. Trade scavenger hunt lists with your partner. Step 5. Make sure you have an adult's permission before you start your scavenger hunt. Step 6. Do your scavenger hunt. How many insects were you able to find? Happy exploring, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!